My name is Luis Mañez. I work as a chief architect at ClearPeople. I'm also an office dev MVP. You can find me on Twitter at Luis Mañez, so feel free to reach out. And in this demo, I'm going to show you how we can send notifications on Microsoft Teams from using the Graph API and from a SPFx web part. The sample is already published at the URL below, so feel free to get the code and give it a try. So, well, we all know what a team notification is. We get a bunch of them at the end of the day. So here in the screen, you can see the anatomy. So there's the avatar. Basically, it used to be the image of the user. The icon, which actually, as far as I've seen, is the Teams application that is sending the notification. Then actor plus reason, the actor who did the activity, and any test with the reason of the notification, a timestamp, and more text with the location and the test preview. The location usually is something like your Teams and channel and so on. And all of this is pretty well documented in the URL in below as well. It's very, very important that you take these requirements if you want to use the API, because otherwise that's not going to work. And first of all, you're going to need to register an Azure Active Directory application. If you are using the SPFx web part, you are using behind the scenes, the SharePoint Online Client Extensibility. And if you want to use the API from outside SPFx, like a bot or any other thing, and we're going to see the demo using just Postman, then you need to register an application in Azure Active Directory, and you have to grant this permission, teamsactivity.send, okay? And also the Teams application manifest needs 1.7 or greater. And when you are creating your Teams manifest, you need to specify a couple of nodes. One is the web application info. And in this section, you need to specify the ID of the Azure Active Directory application, and also the resource, which is actually the reply URL in the app in Azure Active Directory. And also the Teams application must to be installed for the recipient that might be the team or the chat or even the user that you want to send the notification. And finally, you have to specify also in the manifest the activity section, defining the kind of activities, the activity types that you want to use when sending the notification. And for each activity type, you need to specify the type, which is just a unique name in the manifest, a short description, and then the important part, which is the template test. And this is the template that you're going to use later when sending the notification. And you can specify like tokens. And then later when sending the notification, you pass the real values that you want to replace in the template. So with all of these requirements, you're going to be able to use the API. And it's really, really important that the Teams application needs to be installed either in the team or the chat or the user. Otherwise, you're going to get an exception. So once you have the requirements, you can send notifications, for instance, to a specific user. And then you have the endpoint. This is a screenshot from Postman. So you can see we are calling the user's endpoint with the user ID, and then teamwork send activity notification. This is the full endpoint if we want to notify to a specific user. And then we have to provide the body. This is the JSON. So we have the topic section with source property. The source either has to be entity URL or test. The value, which is the topic value, and basically if the source is entity URL, then the value has to be a Microsoft Graph URL, like Microsoft, that Teams, whatever, or something like that. And if you specify test, then it's going to be just a plain test value. And finally, the web URL, which is optional if you are using the entity URL in the source, or if you are using test in the source, then that web URL is going to be the link when the user is going to be redirected inside Teams when you click on the notification. Okay. Then we need to specify the activity type. This activity type has been previously defined in the Teams manifest, as we saw here in the activities. And then you send a preview test with some tests and the different values for the parameters that you want to replace in the template that we define in the activity. So in this case, for instance, if the template test was actor created workspace, workspace title, then you can provide the workspace title. The actor is out of the box, is always be replaced by the entity that is sending the notification. Okay. And if we want to send the notification to a team, then we are posting the request to a different endpoint. Is by the way, this functionality is only available in the beta endpoint. So you are sending the request to beta teams, ID of the teams, and send activity notification with pretty much the same JSON body that we already discussed. But in this case, as you are sending the notification to the team's endpoint, you need to specify the recipient of the notification, which is basically the user ID that you want to be notified. Okay, let's do a quick demo. Basically, this is Postman. So in Teams, I've already installed an application. Let's take a very quick look to the manifest. This is the app that I've already set and installed in Teams. And as you can see here, there's a web application info section where I'm specifying the ID of my Azure Active Directory application. This is an app that is in my Azure Active Directory. You can see here, I've already registered an app and I've already configured the permissions to be able to send notifications. As you can see here, teamsactivity.send. And if we go back to the manifest, the resource is my reply URL and the different activities. I've already registered a couple of activities, workspace created, and just read this, okay, with the template test and so on. So this app has been already installed in different teams, in Microsoft Teams. So I'm gonna be able to send notifications to those teams. So if we go back to Postman and we send this one, for instance, and we go back into Teams, you can see how there's a new notification and it's saying Carol created the workspace with the name and this kind of information. And if you click, you are actually going to the specific, the general channel of the Teams, as you can see here, okay? And if we do the same to a specific user, in this case, we are sending this activity. And now there's a different notification. And if you click here, now you are being redirected to a specific message. And this is because if we take a look to the body, in this case, the source is text and not entity URL. So we are able to provide a URL that we want to be redirect the user when you click in the notification. Keep in mind that at this stage, the URL must start with teams.microsoft.com, but you can point to a specific message in a channel and these kind of things. So this is how it works when using just the raw API from Postman. And if we jump into the web part, my web part is a Teams tab, so I've just added the tab to these Teams in the general channel. So, well, not the best UI in the world, but you can send a message. And you can choose the user for to be notified. And if you send, then this user here is getting another notification. And as you can see, the icon is different because this is the app that I register with my web part, my Teams tab web part. And again, it's going to the channel that I specify in the notification. So this is how it works, the web part, and you can send the notification. So if we go back to the slides, we've already seen this. And let's take a very quick look to the main code. Basically, the web part itself has been installed as a Teams tab. So there's a manifest for the web part. And in the manifest, I'm specifying the web application info section. In this case, the ID is the one from the SharePoint Online application that you already have installed in your Azure Active Directory, and also the different activity types that you want to define in the manifest. So, well, the web part is just loading a React component and sending some properties from the context. As Hugh already mentioned, we are also using here the Microsoft Graph Toolkit, the React wrapper. So Hugo has given you all the information. So I'm using here the People Picker, as you can see from the MGT React. And I'm just configuring the component to show users that are part of the team. This is important because if you try to send a notification to a specific team for a user that is not a member of the team, you're going to get an exception as well. So in this case, I'm filtering the different users by the ones that are part of the team. And well, all the magic is in this function that is pretty much the same as we've already seen in Postman. So we post to the specific teams with the JSON, the activity type defined in the manifest, the test that I've already entered in the UI, and the specific user ID that I want to notify. And using the Graph client from the SharePoint framework, we are doing the post and sending the notification. Well, that's all, actually. The web part maybe is not very interesting, but I guess you can imagine quite a few scenarios where you want to send notifications. And I think this is actually pretty cool to have this endpoint available. That's all from my side, and thank you very much to everyone.
Thank you, Luis.